Music and Arts had a very rounded lineup in its 2016 edition, with artists the size of Patti Smith, Lauryn Hill, Sigur Rós, Air, Kraftwerk, among others. But we wanted to know the highlights and best impressions from the people in the audience, so we went out there and talked to them.
Thank you.
Which artists are you interested to see?
Kraftwerk, because it's, you know, when I was young, I listened to them and I really loved them, so this was the perfect occasion to, you know, relive all the memories.
Sigur Rós yesterday.
Oh, it was amazing.
It was awesome. The light show was perfect.
Yeah.
And then Anna von der Hauswolf. It's really good.
Yeah.
Lone Adair Friday was really good. And of course, Lauryn Hill.
Patti Smith, because I never seen her and I've been a big fan of Patti Smith for like 15 years.
Kraftwerk and also Wintergatan.
Wintergatan and Kraftwerk.
Wintergatan, yeah. Mm-hmm. So I've seen them guys. And then I'll probably go and see Patti Smith. But I'm super psyched to see Kraftwerk.
Kraftwerk.
Yeah. One of the art highlights is Hyperfruit that I've seen, Lauryn Hill. Mm-hmm. On Friday night, she really blew me away.
Joan Baez and Cleo.
Suzanne Vega and then Joan Baez.
Kraftwerk mostly.
Kraftwerk, but as also Suzanne Vega and Air.
Lauryn Hill, who played Friday night. Air, who's playing later this evening.
I would add Michael Kiwanuka.
What are your best impressions of the festival?
It's a good mix of people as well. It's like young people, old people, every kind. It's really nice.
Where the sun is shining, all the people, good music, beautiful area, everything. And the best impression in music was Patti Smith yesterday and Sigur Rós.
I like the festival for its size, its scale, its kind of sophistication. It's just nice atmosphere and some of the art events, obviously, as well.
Grebne Law, I think. It was not really music, but it was in some ways inspiring.
Yes, it was a bizarre, mind-expanding art experience.
People dancing around in weird costumes and singing about... What are they actually singing about?
I don't remember. I just remember them being partly naked.
That part I remember as well, yeah.
That was bizarre, and it made this festival very different.
It's kind of a nice idea to blend music and art.
Most of the best musicians are very visual, have good arts, so I think everything flows together, so it's perfect to have this festival.
What makes Stockholm Music and Arts different from other festivals?
It's in the middle of the city and everyone can go here, and it's just everyone comes together for a nice festival with music and arts.
It's a great neighbor,
it's so easy.
You say.
Yeah. It's so easy.
It's a middle-level city.
And it's also kind of, grown-up festival.
A beautiful location with the water and, you know, and like I said, it's got a real kind of sophistication. The people are nice. It's very kind of... I understand that it's kind of predominantly an older crowd. Yeah. But that's not a bad thing. You know?
I'm
probably kind of in that bracket.
I think the beautiful Stockholm and Skärgården, the big stage out into the just in front of the water, that's very beautiful and very unique.
I would say, to state the obvious, the close integration of music and arts is very successful and feels unique.
You should come here next year.
Great. Nice. An invitation of your people is watching.